In this video, SuperPat77, a principal software engineer at Roblox, teaches you how matchmaking works and experiences, including a breakdown of the different signals used to match players into eligible servers. With the launch of custom matchmaking, it's important to understand how our matchmaking algorithm works so that you can modify it to match players according to the unique needs of your experiences. For more information on the matchmaking process, as well as how to customize it for your experiences, check out the links in the description.
Let's dive into the details of matchmaking. Let's say a player finds your game, they go click the big blue play button, and matchmaking is going to go put them into a server. But how did we actually decide that this was the server to go put them in instead of one of these other servers over here? We have two steps for our process. The first step is what we call eligibility. We need to find servers that are eligible for the user to join. That means filtering out servers that aren't running the right place, or filtering out servers that are already full, like this middle server over here, or maybe you've just launched an update for your game and we need to make sure players don't join servers that we're about to go shut down. We have a series of eligibility checks for all of our instances, and once we run through all of that, we have a list of instances that are eligible for the user to join. The next step is what we call scoring. We have a function that scores every single one of our servers, and whichever one is the highest scoring server, that's the one that the user is going to join. With today's launch of custom matchmaking, you will be able to change how scoring works for your experience so that you can decide whether this player should go to the top server or the bottom server. Now, let's talk through how scoring works. We use an algorithm that we call weighted sum. Weighted sum means that for every server, we have a list of signals like how full the server is, how good your latency is. We're going to go convert this raw data into a value between 0 and 1. We're going to multiply it by a weight. We're going to sum all of those weighted signals together, and that becomes our weighted sum. Let's walk through an example. Now, we have several signals during matchmaking, but to keep things simple, we're just going to use two signals. We're going to use one signal for occupancy, and we're going to use one signal for latency. Now, I mentioned every signal has two parts, a value and a weight. Let's talk about the value first. For the value, we want to be able to convert the raw signal data into some number between 0 and 1. We want to do this so that no matter how different the data is across these signals, we have numbers that we can compare across those different signals. So how do we do this for occupancy? It's pretty simple. We take the number of players, and we divide it by the capacity, the total number of players that could be inside of that server. And that gets us a number between 0 and 1. For this first server up here, we would just take 4 divided by 5, and we would have a signal value of 0.8. For the second server down here, we would take 2 divided by 5, and we would have a signal value of 0.4. But what about latency? What do we divide 100 by? What do we divide 50 by? How do we know how good 50 is versus 100? We have to pick a number, and it has to be consistent across all of our servers so that we can have the same comparison across the board. And we pick the number 250. Now, this isn't to say that you can't join a server that has a ping higher than 250, but it does mean that beyond that point, we might as well use a value of 0. It's no longer relevant for scoring. We want to make sure that we keep this between 0 and 1. So if it is greater than 250, we'll need to make sure that we constrain that. And then, well, this isn't quite right. If you have really good ping, where you have, let's say, only 10 milliseconds of ping, the value is going to be close to 0. So what we actually want to do is take the inverse of this number. And now we're ready to start converting our latency data into signal values. So let's do that. For this first server over here, we would have 1 minus 100 over 250, which is equal to 0.6. And for our second server, we'd have 1 minus 50 over 250, which is 0.8. Now, we could stop here. This is enough for us to compute a score for all of our instances, and let's see what that would look like. If we were to just add these numbers together, these values together, we'd get a signal score, or we'd get a final score of 1.4 for our first instance, and 1.2 for our second instance. And that means just by doing this, we would send the player over to this top server over here. But what if that's not the right trade-off? What if that's not what we wanted to do? What if we say, hey, you know, it's great that this server has a lot of players, but if the player joins the server, their ping's never going to get better. Whereas if they join this server down here, maybe it's okay that there's less players, more could join later. I care more to make sure that they have good ping. So this is where we introduce the concept of weights. Now, weight can be any number between 0 and infinity, it doesn't matter. And we can pick some values. So let's say we picked a value of 1 for the occupancy and 3 for the latency. And let's see how that changes the outcome. Now, we're going to multiply our occupancy signal value by 1 and our latency signal value by 3. And what we find after doing that is that now we have a score for the first instance of 2.6 and a score for the second instance of 2.8. And so now by changing the weights without changing any of the data, the player would be joined to this bottom server over here. This is how the weighted sum algorithm works, and this is how matchmaking works every time a user clicks the play button. We have more signals. Those signals have their own transformation functions to keep those within those values, and they all have different weights. And now you as a developer have the ability to define your own signals using your data and your own weights for our signals and for your own signals. We hope you get a lot of value out of this new feature, and we hope you're able to customize matchmaking to be the best for your experience as player base. Thanks for listening.